Africa. Yes, yes, that he can do. But to plan gentle, men of the jury, no gentleman, this call hold, here holds no plans. What you see here is a thing that acts on command, a thing to hold the handle of a plow, a thing to load your bales of cotton, a thing to dig your ditches, to chop your wood, to pull your corn. That is what you see here. But do you see anything capable of planning a robbery or a murder? He does not even know the size of his clothes or his shoes. Ask him to name the months of the year. Ask him, does Christmas come before or after the 4th of July? Mention the name of Keats, Brian, Scott, and see whatever the eyes will show, one moment of recognition. Ask him to describe a rose, to quote a passage from the Constitution or the Bill of Rights. Gentlemen of the jury, this man planned a robbery. Oh, pardon me, I surely did not mean to insult your intelligence by saying man. Would you please forgive me for committing such an error?
Wow. Yikes. Does anyone find that a good defense?
It's derogatory.
It's very derogatory. But instead of kind of just talking about as a gather together as a class, I want you to kind of get in small groups of two, and just kind of go over, find some quotes, find some just anything that you, even the ones I kind of had you mark in the beginning. Open them up a little bit. Talk about them. Get like three or four. Just jot them down. Write about how it places or gives you an idea of the sense of the social climate. You know, the jobs, the representation of them. You know, what their relation is to whites. All these are very important facets that are a great launching pad for the rest of the novel. So if we can discuss this, we can really understand the expectations that are going to need to be defied in order to kind of overcome the racism. Does anyone have any questions before we get into this activity about what you're required to do? No? We're all set? All right, you're going. Work together. It could be any. It could be from passages we didn't read in the first chapter.
Okay.
Anything you think is noteworthy, even if it doesn't even fit the criteria. Anything that you think is kind of odd or strange, something that needs explaining. How about, are you working with anyone? Are you working with them? Yeah, actually, can you guys do me a favor? And can you maybe explain one of the first sentence of this chapter? I was not there yet. I was there. I didn't go to the trial and not hear the verdict. Kind of maybe with the significance of not being there. What does that say? Why isn't he there? Why doesn't he have to be there? Why is it all the same, his not being there? Or his being there is not the same as being there.
So,
yeah.
So, once we have the quote, you want us to talk about how that quote talks about
Yeah, me. Even if you don't, you know, explain it to the fullest degree, I just want... You know, quotes are the more important thing, so that we can talk about them together.
Okay.
Even just, you know, get them down. Even if you don't think it's that important, just it could be small stuff. Small stuff. They're all. It's all over the place.
I have a couple things in addition to.
Oh great.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't even, like, it takes him away from the tracking system, so it's further separates him from the laws of the nation by setting, like, giving him an alternate origin. You know, he's from the deepest jungle of Black Africa, he's not going to have anything.
And also by saying, Tahori will be straight. It's like inheritance, so that he once was an animal, so it's still correlating him with an animal. So not only is he out of this country, but he's out of this species.
Yeah, it's dehuman, or dehumanizing.
Okay. All right, you guys done talking?
Yeah.
Are you have pretty much what you guys want to talk about? All right, who wants to open it up? Who has anything interesting they want to say? That's something that just kind of jumped out at them. Any, yeah, sure, Linda.
Like, I noticed on page 7 when we were looking at speech of the learned, if you take everything that he's emphasized through, like, M dashes and, like, juxtapose it together, like,
sure.
It proves the complete opposite of, like, what he's trying to say. So, like, the things that he's doing on purpose to get the jury's attention are actually saying, this man, look at him, he can plan this, like, he can do it, like, and I think that emphasizes guilt more than anything else in his, like, long-winded speech.
Right, and I don't know if anyone else reads it like this, but when I'm the idea that I get is that he's not just talking to the jurors, he's kind of shouting at them angrily. His gentlemen of the jury, look at him, look at him, look at this! One of those, just kind of, you know, he's hitting things. Do you see a man sitting here? Do you see a man sitting here? It's almost kind of putting the jurors automatically on the defensive. And I think, well, that's another thing. What do we know about the jurors? Let's go to the court here. What do we know about the social makeup of the judge, the lawyer, the jurors? What are they? I mean, do you know what I'm getting at here?
You pretty much assume they're white.
They're white, all of them. So, and what do we know about our system of law that you're judged by a jury of
your peers?
And I don't know about you, but in the Jim Crow South, these aren't a jury of his peers. These are probably his enemies. So, you know, we can put, you know, not a jury of peers. And there's something else I wanna touch on. I mean, I don't want, without fishing too much, I'll just say it if we don't get it, but what do we know about our system of law? And when someone is accused of a crime, what is the kind of, yes?
Innocent until proven guilty.
Right, and here we see what?
He's guilty and really isn't even getting an attempt at it.
Right, so it's kind of a perversity of the law system already. He's already being set up to fail. Because, you know, what do we know about, and I'm getting that from the line I had you marked off. A white man had been killed during a robbery, and though two of the robbers had been killed on the spot, one had been captured, and he, too, would have to die. They're automatically assuming that, you know, this is going to be the outcome. There isn't going to be any saving grace in this situation, because people don't want to see the saving grace. These are the situations, this is the situation, and in this racist society, people will take that situation and run with it to the electrocution chair. No, the electric chair. Electrocution chair. Okay, so we have court, you know, kind of a reversal of law, of defense even. I I don't know if we got too much into it before, but does, you know, does what other quotes we have before I, you know,